Hey everyone, it's Ashley. Thanks so much for stopping by again today. I'm thrilled to be part of this video hop put on by Justine Hovey. She's recently hit 50,000 subscribers on YouTube, so she has put together this 50 cards for 50K video hop. This is a technique-based video hop, so if you continue on to all of the stops on the hop, you are guaranteed to learn something new or maybe just refresh your memory. There's lots of gift certificates and prizes to be won. All of that information is in the description of the video, as well as links to Justine's blog and the next video in the hop. If after the hop you are still interested in learning even more techniques, Justine's got a class for her technique resource binder going on now, and all of that is linked in the description as well. Let's go ahead and get started on my technique. I'm not even really sure that I would technically call this a technique, which would immediately put me out of the running for this video hop, so I'm not going to say that. What I am going to say is it's very easy. I'm going to be using some Ellen Hudson supplies here, and everything, again, is linked in the description. Lots of information in the description. I also just want to say that there is a glare at the top of my mat here, and I do apologize for that. I had one of the light bulbs in my lighting fixtures blow, so I had to substitute another one in, and it's an overhead, and it just kind of made this glare. So I do apologize for that. It won't be in any future videos. It just happened to happen when I was filming this one. So what I've done is go ahead and have taken some of the outline images, most of them. I think I only left three that are in the stamp set, and I'm creating my own pattern paper, basically. Now, this isn't technically the technique that I'm doing today, but this is also a great one to learn. You don't have to spend tons of money on pattern paper, because if you've got tons of stamps, which we probably all do, you can take the smaller stamps and create your own pattern paper, and I love doing that for my projects. It makes it so much more individual and personalized. Once I've gone ahead and created a sort of pattern, I'm going to go ahead and take the solid stamps that are included in this stamp set, and then I'm going to make sure that I get a bunch of colors that kind of work together and for the theme that I'm going. So I'm using some Stamp Market inks. These are new inks to her line. They are beautiful. I love them so much. They stamp whole and solid, no restamping required. I absolutely love them, and the colors are amazing. So I'm using a lot of colors here that sort of remind me of Halloween, but sort of like a girly Halloween almost. I wanted this to be kind of like a fun girly card, I guess, but actually it ends up turning out to be pretty like suitable for anybody. I just liked the bright colors that I was using here. So I don't have to be perfect with this stamping, and all of this is just for fun, really. So I want to make sure that I had fun with it and that I didn't go too much for perfection. I've gone ahead and taken the coordinating dies, and I've just cut a bunch of them out of some removable or repositionable sticker paper. Now, I buy this by the ream because I just find it very easy. It's a lot cheaper than masking paper, and it works just as well than the ones that I've tried. So this is just, again, some repositionable sticker paper. I've gone ahead and cut out all of the coordinating dies to the images that I've used, and I'm just going to pop them right over those images. Now, this will leave a slight white border around it, but that's the name of the game in this technique. I'm now going to take Citrine, also by the Stamp Market, and go pad to paper and just swipe this across from left to right, and then I'm going to rotate my cardstock and do the same again from left to right, but it will actually go the opposite direction of what I've just done because I'm turning it 180 degrees. So as you can see here, I'm rotating it, and now I'm just going to go from left to right. This is going to make sure that any spots by those stickers, because there's obviously a little bit of dimension when you put a sticker onto a piece of paper, it's going to stick up a tiny bit more. So it's just going to make sure that I get all of the little pieces that maybe I missed going the other way. So next, taking my ink blending brushes that are also from the Stamp Market, I'm going to go ahead and ink blend right over top just to be sure that I soften any of those harsh line edges that I may have gotten from the ink pad to paper technique. I am now removing these masks, and I want to be really careful just to make sure that I don't rip up any of the cardstock underneath. This repositionable sticker paper and masking papers are very gentle, but just to be sure, you want to take some care. And you see these really bright, vibrant images, the same vibrancy as you stamped on the white cardstock, but now we have this really gorgeous citrine background. And I really love the white outline in this technique, but if you're not into the white outline for the masking, you can stamp the stamp directly onto the masking paper and then just cut out very close to the line, and that would omit the white line. Thank you so much for stopping by today. I hope you'll continue the hop with the link in the description. And as always, all of the links to the products are in the description as well. Thanks so much again for stopping by, and I hope to see you again soon. Thank you. Bye.